Today is another fact or fiction, and this has to do with your results that you're getting from your DNA. So let's get started. Here's the question of the day, or the statement really. The results of Ancestry DNA tests are 99.9% accurate and never changing. Now, this statement has a couple of things in it. First off, we have the 99.9% accurate, and we have the never changing. So we need to look at those two separately because they are two separate and distinct statements. Now, the other thing is what we actually mean by our Ancestry DNA results. There's three things that I think you can mean. There is the raw data, there is the matches that you have, and then there is the ethnicity results or the heritage results. So we need to look at those three separately. So we have two things in the statement that have three things relating to it. So there's actually six things. That's not six, that's 10. Six things that we need to be looking at. Let's go and see. Howdy, welcome to Family History Fanatics, where we love helping you climb your family tree and have fun along the way. If you're new to genetic genealogy, chances are you have tons of questions. Be sure to check out the link in the description below for our free guide to the five most common DNA questions that we have answers to. Starting off with the 99.9% accuracy. I guess what we mean by that is that we get the correct result. So when we're talking about raw data, I've already done some videos and shown you some analysis where there are two problems that can happen with our raw data. One is we can have a no call. In other words, the companies, as they're analyzing that DNA, trying to determine what letters it is, they can't determine that for whatever reason. There might be some contamination, there might be other things. And these are usually minimized by analyzing it multiple times, 2 times, 4 times, 10 times, 30 times, and taking whatever the maximum number of the results are. So for instance, if you are gonna plan on analyzing something 4 times, yeah, 1 time you might have some contamination on it, but the other 3 times you probably aren't. And so you'd actually look at what those other 3 results are to find out what the letters are going to be. The other way that your raw data can be wrong is a missed call. For whatever reason, again, as you're analyzing that data, you actually call it as a different letter than what it is. Now, the way that you actually can see this is if you've tested with multiple companies and looking at particular SNPs, where let's say 3 companies call it an AT and 1 company calls it an AA. My assumption there is that 1 company that called it an AA is going to be incorrect, and it's really the consensus of the others an AT. Now, altogether, these errors constitute about 1% of what you are given in your raw data, meaning 99% of what you have is accurate. So is it 99.9% accurate? No, it's about 99% accurate, which is still really, really good. So that's with our raw data. Now let's look at our matches. Well, we have some things that could be errors, but at the same time not. Now remember, with matches, we need to be looking at whether they match on our paternal side or whether they match on our maternal side. Some people match on both, but the vast majority of our matches are on one or the other. Unfortunately, without having one or both of your parents' DNA, you're not going to actually be able to separate out the DNA into what is from the paternal side and what is from the maternal side. So sometimes some of our matches are actually zigzagging back and forth between those two, and they show up as a match. Now, are you going to count this as an inaccuracy? You could, except that it's just looking at the data that it has available. So I'm on the fence on whether I'm going to call that an inaccuracy. But in general, what we do know is that the smaller the segments, the more likely something like that is going to happen. So for instance, if we're looking at, you know, 7 centimorgans, then something like that is going to happen a whole lot more often than if we're looking at a 40 or 50 or 60 centimorgan segment. In fact, at that rate, I think above about 25, 30 centimorgans, from what I've done in some other videos, you don't find any of your matches that are false matches between your two parents. The other issue with this part is, with our matches, is the vast majority of your matches are into these really small segments, 10 centimorgans or less. So for instance, on Ancestry, I have about 30,000 matches, but upwards of 25,000 of them I don't have the data right in front of me, upwards of 25,000, maybe even as much as 28,000 of them are 10 centimorgans or less. So if even just a minor fraction of those 28,000 are these false match types, which it's not a minor fraction, it's actually, you know, pretty large, then it's not truly accurate. So with your matches, I wouldn't say that they're 99.9% accurate, but when I think you're looking at your more closely related matches, let's say anything that is 30 centimorgans or more, yeah, I would say that they're 99.9% accurate for that. And then we get to the ethnicity results. Let's just say you've seen from other videos, no, there's nowhere close to 99.9% accuracy. It's just not possible because we don't have the data. So that's your three for the 99.9% accuracy. With the raw data, it's about 99%. With the match data, if we're looking at 30 centimorgans or greater, yeah, it's about 99.9%. But if we're looking at ethnicity, no, it's nowhere, it's not even nowhere close. It's not even there. There's no real way to actually measure it. So what about the never changing? Well, yes, with your raw data is not going to change. I mean, the only way it's going to change is if they reanalyze your data, if you take another test. So you're not going to see a change in your raw data. If you download a raw data file today and you download that raw data file 10 years from now, when you compare them, it should be the exact same. The matches are determined by those segments. Now, each company is always taking a look at their algorithm as far as how they are determining what a match is, what they're including in, what they're not including in. And so in that case, I think you're going to see some change over time. I don't think that it's going to be never changing. And this is a good thing because the whole point of looking at this as you gather more data is to improve that algorithm. In other words, one of the things that Ancestry did recently was eliminate a lot of the really small matches that they had, and that was a significant number of it. And they eliminated those basically because the majority of those were false matches. Well, that's improving accuracy. If you take out a lot of false matches, even if you're taking out some good matches, knowing that most of those matches are false matches, you've actually improved the overall accuracy of that match list. So your match list is going to change. Now, are you going to see major changes again on the closely related? No, you're not going to. And finally, with our ethnicity results. And this is the one that I think that changes probably the most often. Every year or two, each company does an update, and you find that the percentages that they give you are different, in some cases vastly different. Now, it's usually not going to go from saying that, oh, in this year you were Northwest European, but in the next year, that Northwest European's all gone, and now you're Southeast Asian. It's not gonna be that drastic. It may be moving from, hey, Northwest European to Central European, or from Northwest to Scandinavia, or something like that. As they gather more data, as they increase the size of their reference databases so that they have a better feel for what group might have been in what area based on those reference databases, those results are going to change. And that is the six different ways that you can have accuracy and changes in your DNA results. If you'd like to see what I think the best company in 2021 is, then you can look at this video up top here. But if you want to see something else about DNA, then check out the video down below. This is going to be a great recording session with the allergies.